Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Fardina Siska and today I will presentation about project 1 syntax. Part 1, presentation of part of speech meeting 2. What is syntax? Syntax is the part of the grammar that expresses a speaker's knowledge of sentence and their structure. Structure or word order. The meaning of a sentence depends largely on the order in which words occur in a sentence. Example, she has what a man wants, berbeda dengan she wants what a man has. And however, a change of word order has no effect on meaning. The grammars of a language include rules of syntax that reflect speaker's knowledge of these facts. Grammatical or ungrammatical sequence of words that conform to the rules of syntax are well performed or grammatical, and those that violate the syntactic rules are ill formed or ungrammatical. What grammatically is based on? The ability to make a grammatically judgment does not depend on having heard the sentence before. Example, enormous crickets in pink socks dance at the front. We may never have heard or read it, but our syntactic knowledge tells us that it's grammatical. Also, grammatically judgment do not depend on whether the sentence is meaningful or not. Example, colorless green ideas sleep furiously, or a verb crumpled the milk. Although these sentences do not make much sense, they are syntactically well performed. Part of speech. Sentences are made up of words, therefore it's worth looking careful at different kinds of words. What is most important to us here is the word part of speech, also syntactic category. The most common part of speech are nouns, verbs, adjectives, adverbs, and prepositions. Part of speech tell us how a word is going to function in the sentence. Determining part of speech. The problem of traditional definition. A noun is a person, place, or thing, or that a verb is an action, state, or state of being. It's a very simplistic way of describing various types of words. Additionally, this definition is not very scientific or accurate. Example, destruction, the city bothered the Mongols. The meaning of destruction is not a person, place, or thing. It is an action. But by semantic criteria, this word should be a verb. But in fact, native speakers unambiguously identify it as a noun. It does seem difficult, or if not impossible, to rigorously define the parts of speech based solely on semantic criteria. There are two kinds of distributional tests for determining part of speech. There is morphological distribution and syntactic distribution. Morphological distribution, this refers to the kinds of affix or prefix and suffix and other morphology that appear in a word. This suffix usually result in particular part of speech. For example, if we take the word distribute, we can add the derivational suffix as tion and we get the noun distribution. The tion affix thus creates nouns. Any word ending tion is noun. Second is syntactic distribution. Syntactic distribution refers to what other words appear near the word. For example, in nouns typically appear after determiners or articles such as the, although they need not do so to be nouns. The major part of speech. Noun. Derivational suffix in English, noun often end in derivational ending such as man as basement, nest as friendlands, et as scenery, t as certainty, tion as deviation, ation as expectation, is as specialist, and as attendant. Inflectional suffix. Noun in English do not show much inflection, but when pluralist can take suffix such as S for cats, S for glasses, N for oxen, R for children, E for cacti, and A for attendant. Syntactic distribution. Nouns often appear after determiners such as the, those, this. Example, these peanuts, and can appear after adjective, the big peanut. Nouns can also follow preposition in school. All of these conditions can happen together. For example, in the big gymnasium. Nouns can appear as the subject of the sentence. One easy way to see if something is a noun is to see if you can replace it with another word that is clearly a noun. So if we want to see if the word people is a noun or not, we can substitute another word we know for sure to be a noun. Verbs, derivational suffix, verb often end in derivational ending such as ate for dissipate and easel for easy or regulate. Inflectional suffix, in the past tense, verbs usually take an ed or t ending. In the present tense, third person singular, he, she, it, they take the s ending. Verbs can also take an ing ending in some aspectual contraction. She was walking, and take either an n or an ed suffix when they are passive. Syntactic distribution. Verbs can follow auxiliaries and modals such as will, have, having, had, has, am, be, been, being, is, are, where, was, would, can, could, shall, should, and the special infinitive marker too. Verbs follow subjects and can follow adverbs such as often and frequently. Verb can be negated with not. Adverbs. Derivational suffix, many adverbs end in -ly for quickly, frequently. An inflectional suffix, adverbs generally don't take any inflectional suffix. However, on rare occasion, they can be used operatively and follow the word more. For example, she went more quickly than he did. Adverbs typically don't take the prefix un or unless the adjective they are derived from does first. Example, unhelpfully from unhelpful, but unquickly for unquick. Syntactic distribution. The syntactic distribution of adverbs is most easily described by stating where they can appear. Adverbs can appear between a determined and a noun. The quickly fox, or after the verb, is an experience. Open and close. Some part of speech allow you to add neologisms or new words. New words may be coined at any time if they are open class. Example, fax, internet, grady. By contrast, there are some parts of speech that don't allow new forms. Part of speech that allow new members are said to be open class. Those that don't or were coined are very rare, are closed class. Lexical versus functional. Lexical parts of speech provide the content of the sentence. Nouns, verb, adjective, and adverb are all lexical parts of speech. Functional parts of speech, by contrast, provide the grammatical information. Functional items are the glue that hold a sentence together. One way to tell if a lexical item is functional or lexical is to see if it is left behind in telegraphic speech. Some functional closed categories of English preposition appear before nouns, or more precisely, noun has preposition of English P, for example, to, from, under, over, with, by, at, above, before, after, through, near, on, of, for, in, into, of, during, across, without, since, until. The class of determiners D is a little broader. Determiners appear at the very beginning of English noun phrase. It contains a number of subcategories including articles, for example, the, a, an, dietetic article, for example, this, that, this, those. Quantifiers, for example, every, some, many, most, few, all, each, any, less, few, fewer, no. Cardinal numerals, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4. Possessive pronouns, for example, my, your, his, her, its, our, their. Some, who, question, word, for example, which, whose. Conjunction or con are words that connect two or more pressed together on an equal level. Conjunction of English, for example, an, or, nor, neither, nor, either, or. The class of complementizer C also connect structure together, but they embed one clause inside of another instead of keeping them on an equal level. Complementizers of English, for example, that, for, if, whether. Tense or T are consist of auxiliaries, modals, and the non-finite clause marker. Auxiliaries, for example, have, has, had, am, is, are, was, where, do. Modals, for example, will, would, shall, should, can, could. Non-finite tense marker, for example, to. Subcategories and features. Subcategories of nouns, plural versus singular, proper versus common, pronoun versus lexical noun, and count versus mass noun. English noun can be either singular or plural. Its distinction between singular and plural is usually morphological, marked with one of the plural ending, although it need to be mice or dear. Singular nouns in English require a determiner or D. Plural nouns do not require determiners, although they allow one, proper names and common nouns. There are really two major ways. One is along the lines of tense. For example, whether the verb is left, leaves, will left, or to left. The other way to divide up verbs in terms of the number of noun phrase NPs and prepositional phrase or PPs or clauses CPs that they require. The second kind of division is known as argument structure. Part 2, solve all the problem and make three diagrams and explain. First, Aldi went to the cinema last week. So first, sentence terus dibawahi dengan NP or noun phrase dan verb phrase. Dari noun phrase ini diturunkan kata noun yaitu Aldi. Lalu dari verb phrase itu diturunkan menjadi tiga bagian yaitu verb, preposition phrase, and adverb phrase. Verb itu when, and preposition phrase diturunkan lagi menjadi preposition and noun phrase. Preposition itu to, noun phrase itu diturunkan lagi menjadi determiner and nouns. Determiner itu di, de, and noun itu cinema. And adverb phrase is last week. Second, the faster runner won a gold medal at the Olympic. Sentence diturunkan menjadi dua bagian yaitu noun phrase and verb phrase. Noun phrase ini diturunkan menjadi dua bagian lagi yaitu determiner and adjective phrase. Determiner itu de atau di, and adjective phrase is diturunkan lagi menjadi dua bagian yaitu adjective and noun. Adjective itu faster and noun itu runner. Verb phrase itu diturunkan menjadi tiga bagian yaitu verb, noun phrase, and preposition phrase. Verb itu one, and noun phrase itu diturunkan lagi menjadi dua bagian yaitu determiners and noun. Determiners itu a, and noun itu gold medal. Preposition phrase diturunkan menjadi dua bagian yaitu preposition and noun phrase. Preposition itu as, noun phrase itu diturunkan lagi menjadi dua bagian yaitu determiners and noun. Determiners itu the, and noun itu Olympic. Number 3 is the old and big tree swayed in the hurricane. sentence diturunkan menjadi dua bagian, yaitu noun phrase and verb phrase. Noun phrase ini diturunkan menjadi tiga bagian, yaitu determiners, adjective phrase, and noun. Determiners itu the atau the. Adjective phrase itu diturunkan menjadi tiga bagian, yaitu adjective, conjunction, and adjective lagi. Adjective pertama itu old, conjunctionnya itu and, adjective terakhir itu big. Noun-nya itu three. Dari verb phrase itu diturunkan menjadi dua bagian, yaitu verb dan preposition phrase. Verb itu sweet, dan preposition phrase diturunkan lagi menjadi dua bagian, yaitu preposition dan noun phrase. Preposition itu in, noun phrase itu diturunkan lagi menjadi dua bagian, yaitu determiners and noun. Determiners itu de atau di, and noun itu hurricane. Number 4, the youngest sister put the doll in the purse. Sentence diturunkan menjadi dua bagian, yaitu noun phrase dan verb phrase. Noun phrase itu diturunkan lagi menjadi tiga bagian, yaitu determiners, adjective phrase, and noun. Determiners itu the atau the. Adjective phrase diturunkan lagi menjadi adjective, yaitu youngest, and noun itu diturunkan menjadi sister. Verb phrase itu diturunkan menjadi dua bagian, yaitu verb, noun phrase, and preposition phrase. Verb itu put, noun phrase itu diturunkan menjadi dua bagian, yaitu determiners and noun. Determiners itu the, and noun itu doll. Preposition phrase diturunkan lagi menjadi dua bagian, yaitu preposition and noun phrase. Prepositionnya itu in, sedangkan noun phrase-nya itu diturunkan lagi menjadi dua bagian, yaitu determiners and noun. Determiners-nya itu the, dan noun-nya itu whose. The last is, the big girl saw a lizard with a lovable panda recently. Sentence diturunkan menjadi dua bagian, yaitu noun phrase and verb phrase. Noun phrase ini dibagi menjadi tiga bagian, yaitu determiners, adjective phrase, and noun. Determiners-nya itu the, dan adjective ini diturunkan menjadi adjective, yaitu big. Noun-nya ini girl. Verb phrase diturunkan menjadi tiga bagian, yaitu verb, noun phrase, dan adjective phrase. Verb-nya itu saw, dan noun dari noun phrase ini diturunkan lagi menjadi noun, yaitu a laser. Sedangkan adverb phrase ini dibagi menjadi tiga bagian, yaitu preposition phrase, noun phrase, dan adverb. Preposition phrase ini diturunkan menjadi preposition, yaitu with, dan noun phrase-nya ini dibagi lagi menjadi tiga bagian, yaitu determiners, adjective, and noun. Determiners-nya itu a, adjective-nya itu lovable, noun-nya itu panda, dan adverb phrase diturunkan menjadi adverb. Adverbnya itu recently. Mungkin hanya itu saja yang saya presentasikan. Kurang lebihnya mohon dimaafkan. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.